So, as you saw at the start there, I've made some more progress on my hole. Let me give you a little tour. It goes all the way, whoa. Frame rate. What are you doing? My frame rate just dropped then, sorry. I've been getting a very stable 30 FPS in the recording for this lately, but maybe my big old hole is a little bit intensive on my game. I don't know. Anyway, I've dug it down. I've reached level 13, down to diamond level. And here's our portal to the end, which we can't get to just yet. So I've still got a few more levels to go down, a few more blocks to go before I reach bedrock. And I just want to completely clear it just to be completely certain that there's no other hidden treasure. Like this lava, there might be something hidden under that. I don't know, maybe. I don't want to lose the lava, but I guess we'll find out. But today, I don't want to do digging today, because I did a lot of digging yesterday. I don't feel like doing that now. I want to do some building. I want to put some new floors into my base and start actually putting things in my base. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start putting in farms. Basically all these farm things that I've got up the top here, I want to move them down underground. So cows, piggies, chickens. Yeah, move them down there somewhere as well. I want to put them fairly low down so that they're quiet. I need a tree farm down there, or just a place where I can plant and grow trees. And sugarcane and wheat and all the things. So yeah. That's the plan for today, and then next episode we'll make some more progress on actually going to the Nether and stuff. Alright, so let's get some blocks and have a look at what we can do first. So I think the first thing I want to do is get a tree planting area so I can move my trees from the top. And I've got all these blocks here to build out of. I'm thinking andesite is nice. I haven't got a huge amount of this though, so don't want to use too much. I've got crap tons of cobblestone, but because I can't really grow trees very quickly, I can't make a huge amount of coal. Yeah, I can. Okay. Let's cook up some charcoal. Let's just go ahead and do that. And then I can cook up some smooth stone for building out of. There we go. Yeah, I'll cook up some smooth stone, we can get stone bricks and get slabs, all those things. So, the first platform I want to put in, I also want some wood. Let's get some of this stuff. Building blocks, hooray. Oh yeah, I made these ready to put upstairs. I was just going to go ahead and put a little protective fence around here so that if we get any animals spawning in, they don't wander off and fall into holes. Yes, yes, yes. Right. So the first platform is going to be the tree growing platform, and it needs to be 7 blocks down from this one. See if we can reach that. Okay, 7, and then that's where I want the floor. Right there. Dun-dun. Very nice. So I guess I kind of, how am I gonna do this? Where do I actually wanna put the tree to plant? In the middle maybe? Or should I do several places to plant trees? I can make a big floor here. Doesn't have to be open at all. I think I might just start placing andesite. Ooh, I need to be really careful not to fall from here though. Oh, so the in this texture pack, the smooth andesite is like andesite stone bricks, which looks kind of nice. Wait, what's it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Some torches down. Building with fire gear. Here we go. Get rid of this one as well. Boop. So I'm thinking something like that, and then we'll have a connection from the backside here, the same way I've done that first platform, using wood. Wood slabs. We'll have like a little walkway around the backside to reach the platform. So that's the center. Oops. Something like that, maybe. Oops. Don't worry, I can go down. Pick these blocks up. I could put this walkway all the way around the edge of the room. I think that might look good. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Let's get rid of this bit actually. Oh yeah. I think it's because there's such an open area. The lighting updates cause massive lag spikes, don't they? That's why you gotta be careful when you're digging holes in this game. If you do them too big, you start getting these horrible lighting lag spikes. Right, so there's my first platform, or my first level in my new base. I think now I want to put this trim around the edge of this storage platform, and I'm thinking logs. Just like this. I'll actually just continue this like that and just do them all the way along. Let's try and pick up speed here a little bit, deciding where I'm going to put the next platform and stuff. So the animals I want far enough away that I'm not going to hear them, but one thing you may have noticed is that at least one of these chunks is a slime chunk. So I need to be careful not to get slime spawns down up in my base. So slimes, I believe, spawn up to level 40 in slime chunks. So that's annoying. Yeah, that's going to be a problem. Crap. I need to work out which of these chunks, because this isn't one chunk, this is four chunks right here. I need to work out which ones are the slime chunks, or if they're all slime chunks, because otherwise I'm going to get slimes up in my base, and that's not very nice. I don't want slimes. Or else I'm going to have to make my animal pens out of slabs so we don't get slime spawning. Maybe I'll just do that. Yeah, I think I'll just do that. When I first started playing this version, I completely forgot that you can grow trees with bone meal. So I was thinking I was going to have to make some big old tree farm. It's going to require loads of things, but I can actually just go ahead and bone meal it whenever I need wood, can't I? Although, kind of slow. So I need a good mob spawner to make doing all this stuff much easier. Bom bom. So yeah, I've been living off apples this whole time. Like that's all I've had to eat. They've really kind of screwed up the food system in the latest versions, apparently. I don't know why they've done that. Ooh, sugarcane harvest. I guess too many people were getting annoyed with having to eat all the time, but why even bother having a food system if you're not gonna need to eat? Seems kind of silly. And you know, the purpose of pretty much, well, the purpose of most of the animals, especially pigs, is just to feed the character. If I can survive off just the one or two apples that I've been getting from chopping down trees, that's kind of crazy. Bum bum, put charcoal away. You can't make charcoal blocks yet, can you? No. Because they never put that in. Righty ho. Let's see where we're up to. I would love some more types of wood, but I'm currently the only other tree type I've seen is the dark oak that's up on that platform or up on that floating island. And I need a lot of saplings to get dark oak, don't I? So I can't really get those yet. I'm hoping that I get given more saplings in chests fairly soon, because building everything out of wood and stone or plain oak and stone, it's not going to look very nice. Right, so this is where I want to put the animals. How am I going to lay this out? Okay, viewers, I think I know what I'm doing for my farm area and my animal pens. I'm thinking down here is where I'm going to do my farmland. I'm just going to have the two small plantations of things. I'm going to make them, I don't know, slightly offset from one another. Let's see. And I'm doing this checkerboard pattern with the old granite and diorite. So I'm thinking another plantation here. Just fill this in. So this is a 5x5, that's a 5x5, and then we'll just have one as wheat and then the other one as whatever. What other crops we may need to grow? Because I mainly just need wheat for breeding, don't I? Don't really need it for food. Right, and then boom, 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 boom. There we go. And I need some water down here to like do it properly. And I was thinking putting trapdoors along the edges might look nice. Let's go get some trapdoors and try that. See how that looks. I got this step here just so that you can get down. Actually, I might just put the polished granite along the edge. should look a bit neater. Just like that. There we go. So we just have a little step to get down. I definitely need to do something about the lighting. It's probably gonna be in the walls as soon as I expand. And then we'll have some other lighting from the ceiling, maybe. I'm not certain yet. So yeah, this is what the farmland will be like. And then further down, we'll have another level for something else. I don't know what. And then we'll have some animal pens, which I'm still working out here. And I'm just going to have pigs and cows. And we'll put the chickens, and if we get sheep, we'll put sheep somewhere else. Come on, ladies. Out you come. Some weird looking graphical glitches there. I've never noticed that before. There we go. Apparently I bred these up a lot more than I thought I had. We're going to have a few cows to kill here. Come on, ladies. It's time for the culling. We'll just try and get at least two in the pen. And that'll be good enough. I think this place is going to look pretty good once I got the walls in. Right now it looks a bit weird with the border, but I can expand it in just a second. I'm just doing this first. Come on. Down we go. You did now. Alright, so I've got 9 leather. That's good, coming along. Fair bit of sugarcane building up. Okay, what are we doing next? Bum bum bum. I'm gonna expand. Okay, I'm gonna make this cake. It's been on the list of things to do for quite some time. Let's make a cake. Sugar. Eggs. It's 2 eggs and 1 sugar, right? Not the other way around. Okay. 2 sugar, 1 egg. Cake. Glorious cake. That's expanding. Yeah. So I can finally replace my walls. I can start decorating properly in here. Oh, that looks so much nicer. Look at this place. And I'm going to have to fill in all these gaps and make certain we don't get any monsters spawning around here. These dark bits that have just opened up. Right there. That bit's fine. Right, these are dangerous sections here. So, before I finish off the episode, I'm going to go and dig out a bit more stuff. I want to finish digging out all the way down to bedrock. Let's put this in here. I don't need that buckets no more. Check this out, viewers. I found something. I found something suspicious. It's a block of silverfish. And I'm betting that there's a chest hidden in here. I knew I'd find stuff if I'd patiently dug away all this crap. These guys are sneaky. The moment I found that sugar cane hidden in like a block of stuff, of stone and stuff, I knew they were sneaky. Oh, we got some obsidian down here as well. It's interesting. So I think what I'm going to do, I've got my flint and steel. I'm just going to free these guys one at a time. take them out of the flint and steel. I mean, this looks like it's been placed purposely. It may have been that they did it by mistake. But I don't think so. Oh, no. It looks like they're expecting me to mine the obsidian to get into this thing. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Dig around a little bit more. Can we see what it is from under here? It's a birch sapling. I tricked it. I sneaked it out. Ooh, some lava down here. I don't really care that much about this lava. Yeah, birch trees! I thought it would be something a bit more valuable than that, but I guess in a captive world that is kind of valuable. I was saying I want some new types of wood, although I would not have chosen birch as my first choice. Let's drop this one down and get ourselves a little birch tree. Check out these apples. These things are keeping me fed. I honestly don't need to eat anything else but apples. It's kind of silly. Right. I don't really like these wooden slabs on this floor. I would prefer to have like dark oak or spruce or something. I'll replace them later though. So, yeah, I'm still working on all this shit. Like this. Dun, dun, dun. Got any diorite on me right now? There we go. Use those last ones up. I'm still wondering if there's anything else hidden down here. Because there could be. There are spaces where there could be things hidden. But I don't think it's going to be a fortune book, so I'm just going to... I think I might just call it there. Let's just do a little like strip mine thing to see if there's anything else hidden. Poke some holes. Because it doesn't look like there is, right? Oh, that's some lava. A little diagonal one here. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and mine the diamonds, get that final achievement for today. And then in the next episode, we can construct a nether portal and go through. The last place where they may have hidden things is inside the lava pool, because this right here, everything under here is lava, all the way down to here. So there's a big old space in there. They could have hidden stuff, but it'll be a bit of a hassle to get in there and see. So I don't think it's worth the effort right now. See, it's just all solid lava. Yeah, let's mine the diamonds. Here we go, final achievement for today's episode. My boots have broken. How do I do this? There we go. Achievement time. Boing! Diamonds for Bayoki. Oh yeah. Sweet. I kind of wish I had not done that actually. I just realized I don't need a diamond pickaxe to get the obsidian to make a portal, because I can just use lava. Whoops. Well, I may have just wasted some diamonds. It's fine. I'm sure it's fine. Anyway, guys, I think I'll call it quits for tonight's episode right there. I can finally decorate my house a little bit better, or I can decorate the walls. So I'll probably do that off camera. Yeah, I'll probably do that off camera and do a bit more tidying up and decorating around here. And then in the next episode, we will go to the Nether. Make some real progress. So, I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye. Whoa.